James chapter 1 and verse 2. Praise God. Sometimes we need to be reminded. Is everybody there?
Amen.
James chapter 1 and verse 2. Let's speak it. My brethren, count it all miserable. Count it all what?
Joy.
Why? Because you have the power to what? Choose. Count it all joy when? When you fall into various trials. Again, that doesn't say if. You will fall into various trials. You will be tempted. You will be brokenhearted. You will have pains. You will have sorrows. You will have sufferings. You will be rejected. You will be hated. Welcome to the earth. It's a fallen place. It's ruled by demonic activity that hates mankind. Hello. And these demons will use anyone they can, even your best friend. Until an individual's unplugged, you got to be careful. Unplugged from what? The world. Unplugged into eternity. But on that, the devil will use them to get to you. So listen, you will fall into trials, various trials, multiple kinds of things. Why? Verse 3. Knowing that the what? Testing of your faith produces patience. Now, I want you to understand this. This is the testing of your connection. Because faith is what connects you, whether you're connected or not. Because if you're not connected, you're going to go to do whatever you want. It's a terrible thing to be disconnected when the boat sinks. It's a terrible thing to be disconnected when you're caught in a fire or in an accident or in a trial or a tribulation. Because only through your connection are you rescued. Other than that, you pay the price. Verse 4, it says, but what? Let patience, which is also known as endurance. Why? Because God gives you the power to endure through what? Trials and tribulations, afflictions, conflicts, rejections, fears, temptations. Why? Because your faith connects you to home. And if you're staying connected, you're an overcomer of this world. So the enemy wants to disconnect you. Some people still just ain't connected yet because they're not unplugged from the world. They still want the world and they want God, but you can't have both. But let patience have its what? Perfect work. In other words, you have a choice. Allow this to perfect you. Why? That you may be perfect and complete, lacking nothing. What do you mean? Because let these trials and tribulations teach you so that we're not stupid to do them again. Hello? So that we are connected. So we don't do the same thing over and over and over because of being disconnected and come to the reality that you need connection because you don't belong in this world. You're just passing through. Verse 5 says, if any of you lacks wisdom, hello, let him ask of God who gives it all what? Liberally or freely, without reproach, and it will be given to him. Wisdom. Wisdom tells you what to do. Tells you what? What to do. But you're not going to be connected to the wisdom eternally if you're not connected to him personally. Y'all got it? That wisdom won't come from above. It will come from the earth, from the world. And the worldly wisdom is called demonic. You'll live by a sense of your senses of carnal reasoning instead of spiritual discernment. Has everybody got this? It says, let them ask in what? And if anyone lacks, let him ask of God who gives to all liberally without reproach, and it'll be given to him. Verse 6, but let him ask in what? Faith, knowing that you are connected. Because you're not going to get nothing if you're not connected. With no what? Doubting, because you always doubt. You will challenge God instead of surrender to Him. Does everybody get this? And when you're challenging God, it means you're disconnected. For he who doubts is like a wave of the sea driven and tossed by the wind. For let not that person suppose that he's going to get what? Anything from the Lord. Like I said. Why? Because they're disconnected. He is double-minded, unstable in all their ways. In other words, they can't be trusted. And God ain't going to give someone he can't trust. Trials, tribulations, these are troubles. Has everybody got it? Troubles. This world is going to give you troubles. Hello. So there's an area where, you know, the word says you can't, double-minded means serving two masters, and you can't serve both. Where, there's that fight within us, amen? That fight within, the one from above wants to cut us loose from the world. The old man wants to cut you loose from eternity. There's that fight within, always. See, to be connected to heaven, you must be disconnected from hell. That means you must be disconnected from the earth and be connected to eternity. So you are kingdom-minded. You think about kingdom. In other words, everything is associated is, you know, your first always goal is eternity. Every decision that you make, there should be an arena of, am I going to break covenant with God, or am I going to maintain covenant with God? That's called eternity. But then there are decisions that you and I need to make on a daily basis of wisdom from above, whether it be at work, whether it be purchase. No matter what you're doing, that decision must come from, that wisdom must come from above, so that the decision is according to God's will and not man's will. Amen? So in this, there's that area where you and I stay connected so that we can receive all and lack nothing. Overcome anything that the world can bring across your path. You know, you will be a sign and wonder at your job. You will be a sign and wonder to your neighbors. In fact, you'll be a sign and wonder to yourself sometimes. In Matthew 7. My encouragement is a source of what God says, His promises and His word, His love and His presence. Does everybody get it? People can come in and encourage you and say, look at all things are going to be good. But you're to encourage people by the word of God, not by what your emotions are. Oh, Gucci, Gucci, goo. It's okay. You just keep sinning. It's going to be fine. Right. Deuteronomy 1. Hallelujah. So there is a fight constantly to stay connected, isn't there? And Matthew 7 and verse 13. Let's speak it together, please. It says what? Enter by the narrow gate, for wide is the gate, and broad is the way that leads to destruction. And there are many who go in by it. Many. Many. Because narrow is the gate, and difficult is the way which leads to life. And there are few who what? Who find it. Beware of false prophets. Beware of false prophets. Beware of individuals that speak false hope. That speak what? False hope. Beware of false prophets who come to you in sheep's clothing, but inwardly they are ravenous wolves. Verse 16. You will know them by their fruits. Do men gather grapes from the thorn bushes or figs from thistles? Even so, every good fruit bears good, every good tree bears good fruit, but every bad tree bears bad fruit. A good tree cannot bear bad fruit, nor can a bad tree bear good fruit. Every tree that does not bear good fruit is cut down and thrown into the fire. Therefore, by their fruits you will what? You will know them. You're going to know them by their fruits. You're going to know where you stand. You're going to know whether you're connected by your fruits. Do you doubt? Do you fear? Do you lust? Do you lie? Do you cheat? Well, those are fruits of carnality of the world. If you're doing those fruits, you're disconnected from God. You die in that condition. You don't make it home. That's a bummer. Why? Because he said, every tree that does not bear good fruit is cut down and thrown into where? The fire. The tree is called, known as the spirit of a man. Verse 21. Not everyone who says to me, Lord, Lord, that means they knew him as Lord, amen, shall enter the kingdom of heaven, but he who does the will of my Father in heaven. So there's a lot of people out there thinking that they're doing God's will. Amen. And calling him Lord. And many will say to me in that day, Lord, Lord, have we not what? Prophesied in your name. Woohoo! Moved in the gifts of the Spirit. Cast out demons in your name. Listen, God will use anyone. But there's a day you have to stand before him and give account. No matter how much God has used you, never determine how much God uses someone or where they are. You're to discern by the fruit. God never interrupts himself. Anyone that allows someone, the enemy, to use them to interrupt is disconnected. Does everybody understand that? Remember, the enemy disconnects. That's his job. He does it very well. And like I said, there's still people who are not even connected yet. There are believers, so-called believers, that are 30-year believers and still not connected. In fact, the word says to them, he warns them, he says, you search the scriptures thinking you have eternal life, but you won't come to me. Whoa, so they know the word. But they're still doing their will. Many will say to me in that day, Lord, Lord, have we not prophesied, cast out devils, done many wonders in your name? And he's going to say, listen, man. Then I will declare to them, I never knew you. Why? Because they were not connected. Does everybody understand that? Depart from me, you who practice what? Lawlessness, rebellion, or disobedience. Therefore, whoever hears these sayings of mine and does them, I will liken him to a wise man. That wisdom is from above, because he's connected, and builds his house on the rock, which is the anointing. And the rain descended, the floods came, the trials and tribulations come. Troubles come. And the winds blew and beat on that person. But it did. They didn't fall. They didn't drift. They didn't fall away. They stayed connected. For it was founded on the rock. Because they still filled with the Spirit. They stayed connected. They didn't allow the influence of the world to disconnect them. But everyone who hears these sayings of mine and doesn't do them. Does everybody see that? Will be a foolish man. Idiot or moron, who built his house on the sand. And the rain descended, the floods came, they went through trials and tribulations, they were tested. But they were overtaken. And great was their fall. Does everybody get this? Why? Not connected. Not connected. See, if you're still connected to anything in this world, you're disconnected from him. It doesn't mean you don't love people, but you're not connected to, they're not your source. Amen? He's your source. Everything else is a resource. Let me share again. One of the things the enemy does is bring false hope. It is so important that we grab hold of this. False hope. Listen, God's sayings are promises of truth, love, hope, faith, a future. Amen? What he does is he brings encouragement. I'm going to say that again. God brings the encouragement. When you're waiting for man to constantly encourage you, you're not connected. Does everybody get it? There's nothing wrong with encouraging one another. But if that is your source of encouragement, you're disconnected. Your source of encouragement should be through the promises of God Almighty, what He says, by His Spirit of confirmation and witness within you. That's your encouragement. Everything else is false hope. His sayings, His promises, and truth. The fallen world is ruled by deception from an evil force that thrives on causing mankind to be discouraged, oppressed, greedy, jealousy, hateful. They release lies. They love. Their purpose is releasing lies of false hope. They release lies of false hope. And trapping people to come against each other, unable to find or hold on to the true identity of children of God. How quickly people sell their birthright for a paycheck, for a night of lust, for a night of getting high or pleasing a man. It's terrible to be disconnected. It's a terrible place. There is no encouragement. No matter what man says to you, it is temporary. The only way that you stay encouraged is by what God says to you, which brings you true hope and not false hope. And that's what's happening right now. The enemy is releasing such false hope and promises through government, through all kinds of stuff, through music, through radio, through TV, through movies. All of this false hope and fantasies. But when you're connected, you can discern those things. You don't allow those things. In other words, you don't say to yourself, oh, I want to be just like that movie star. No, you want to be just like Jesus. You want to be the man of God and the woman of God that pleases God. That's your desire. That should be your desire. If it's not, then you're disconnected. Pretty cool? Why? Because you've lost your identity. Only by maintaining connection you maintain identity. Then you maintain true hope. But false hope, in other words, having other people encourage. False hope, having other people encourage. My encouragement is not the source of man. My encouragement is the source of what God says, His promises and His word, His love and His presence. Does everybody get it? People can come in and encourage you and say, look at all things are going to be good. But you're to encourage people by the word of God, not by what your emotions are. Oh, Gucci, Gucci, goo. It's okay. You just keep sinning. It's going to be fine. Right. Deuteronomy 1. This is a tremendous thing that's happening right now. The enemy is influencing adults, young adults, even elders with false hope, bringing false encouragement. And he uses technology. That's his job. That's why there's so much technology. Man, you got rid of technology today, we'd have to talk to one another. You'd have to be accountable to one another. Hallelujah. Verse 20. Look, the Lord your God has set the land before you. Go up in what? Oh, that's 21. All right, let's start at 20. And I said to you, you have come to the mountains of the Amorites, which the Lord our God is giving us. Look, the Lord your God has set the land before you. Go up and what? How do you possess something? You got to take it. By what? Force. You see, the world says, gimme, gimme, gimme. God says, take it, take it, take it. You take it by force, the things of God. Listen, my dad owns this world still. The ruler might be Satan. My dad still owns it. He's got the last say. Amen. Satan's only out on bail. But one day his bail's gonna, he's gonna get before, he's gonna have to appear in court and get sentenced. He ain't gonna outrun that, man. And anyone who's following Satan is gonna follow him right in the same courtroom and get sentenced right along with him. Go up and possess. Take it in the name of Jesus. What? The promises of God. Take it. And the Lord, as the Lord God of your fathers has spoken to you, and do not what?
Fear.
Do not what?
Fear,
fear or what?
Discouraged.
Be discouraged. Why? Because those two things will disconnect you. Do not fear or be discouraged. Discouraged. Everyone say discouraged.
Discouraged.
Discouragement is false hope. That's the result of false hope, is discouragement. Fear and discouragement prevent the true possession of God's promises and the next level of advancement. I'll say it again. Fear and discouragement prevent the true possessions of God's promises and next level of advancement. In John 16, the teaching today is called False Hope, in case you haven't figured that out yet. Glory. John 16, verse 1. Hallelujah. Verse 1, these things I have spoken to you that you should not be made to what? Stumble. They will put you out of synagogues for speaking the truth, raising your hands and praying in tongues. And even doing the Holy Ghost shuffle some other places. Yes, the time is coming that whoever kills you will think that he offers God a service. Isn't that wild? We are in that time. You know how many Christians are being killed all over the world? See, people are so short-sighted, they don't see. They're so caught up in their technology and whatever's close to them. They have no idea that in other countries, Christians are being murdered. And it will enter this country. It actually has entered this country, but it's not being spoken of, or the media, because the media is wicked. But there are people, there are shootouts and all kinds of stuff going on right now between the righteous and the unrighteous. It's happening in this country. Kids are being persecuted in school for bringing Bibles. Kids are being sent home for reading their Bibles. These are kids that are on fire for God. They don't care about what man says. They care about what God says. It's happening all over the world. But people are being beheaded. See, that's what the enemy does. I mean, you hear about people being beheaded all over the world. People going into schools and shooting them, thinking they're doing something for a demon called Allah. Hello. He's nothing but a fallen angel demon. And he hangs around with a fat jolly demon called Buddha. And all the rest of the idiots. They're all nothing but demonic forces. influencing man with false religion and false hopes, misleading them and leading them to hell. And Buddha still can't drink coffee. Hallelujah. I mean, you don't think about that. It's crazy, isn't it? Let's give a statue a cup of coffee. Well, look what they did with the statue of Mary. They put roses in front of her. They do all kinds of stuff, man. I've been over in other countries. And they carry statues down the street. And then they go to the Pope's house, the Vaticanites. And they bow before a man, kiss his feet, and kiss his hand. They need to slap him in the head and tell him to wake up and get filled with the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. These are all false hopes. Go to a confession and tell your sins to a dude that's sinning anyways. Calls himself father. Probably hiding out because he's a fornicator. Anyways, pedophile, that's what they are. Anyways, where are we? And so there are people that are out there thinking that they're in a service for God, but they're actually misleading people with false hope because they're deceived, so they just pass it on to someone else. And these things they will do to you because they have not known the Father nor me. That's what he says. But these things I have told you that when the time comes, you may remember that I told you of these things. And these things I did not say to you at the beginning because I was with you. But now I'm going to go away to him who sent me, and none of you ask me where I'm going. But because I have said these things to you, sorrow has filled your heart. Nevertheless, I tell you the truth. I tell you the truth. It's to your advantage that I go away. For if I do not go away, the helper who interprets all truth, who exposes all false hope and all lies, will come to you. Why? He's the connector. He's the one that's going to connect you. You'll have a witness within you. You will hear his voice, and you'll be led. You will receive conviction, counsel, correction, and direction. And he'll cause you to walk in my way if you let him. When a helper comes, which I will send to you, in verse 8. And when he has come, he will convict the world of sin and righteousness and of judgment, of sin because they don't follow me, of righteousness because I go to my Father and you see me no more, and of judgment because the ruler of this world is judged. Like I said, he's out on bail right now. But he's going to have to show up. He's going to appear in court. He can't outrun God. He can't miss court. He can't extend court. He's going to appear in court. I still have many things to say to you, but you can't bear them. You can't interpret them. You can't understand them yet. However, when the Spirit of truth, who's going to guide you all to truth, he's going to come, and he will guide you into all truth. And he will not speak on his own authority, but he's going to speak what he hears from the throne room of God. And he will tell you things to come. But if you're not connected, you're not going to know what he's saying. Or if your heart is hardened, you're going to reject everything he says. Especially when he brings conviction, counsel, correction, and direction. He's going to glorify me, for he take of what is mine and declare it to you. And all the things that the Father has are mine. Therefore, I said that he will take of mine and declare it to you. Many sin, lie, kill, steal, and think it's okay with God. Because they think they're doing it for God. Do you know that the Quran says it's okay to lie? That's why Obama can lie and say he's a Christian. That's why he can lie to the people. He's got no problem lying because he sure ain't a Christian. He's Muslim. And don't let any doubt come about that. He is Muslim. He was raised a Muslim, believes in, lives it. He's a Muslim. And that's why he promotes things. So everybody got this. This country's been ruled by demonic force and a false religion bringing false hope. That's why he can lie like crazy in front of all mankind and in front of all Americans. He's been lying from the beginning, and they're going to remove him. And they're going to disconnect all of his lies and false hopes. and bring reality and truth, because God is answering the prayers of the saints and interrupting Satan's agendas. Because we are entering a time of plenty in preparation for the return of the Lord. Oh, glory. Again, many sin, lie, steal, kill, and think that it's okay with God because they think they're doing it for God. You know, we're to fight. The Holy Spirit gives you the encouragement, the strength, and the ability to fight for what is truth. Why? So you maintain connection. This is called false hope by the enemy, invoked by evil influences, not knowing the truth, to compare or reject truth. They don't know what to compare or reject because they don't know the truth. They don't know the promises of God. False promises. Let me tell you, false promises end up in big discouragements. Causes separation from the will of God and causes disconnect. Psalm 121. False hope. Psalm 121, verse 1. Let's speak it so we eat it. Hallelujah. Is everybody there? Okay, let's speak this, please. I will lift up my eyes to the hills. From whence comes my help or my encouragement? My help comes from the Lord who made heaven and earth. I will not allow your foot to be moved. He who keeps you will not slumber. Behold, he who keeps Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is your what? Your keeper. Now, who is the Lord? He's known as the Spirit. He's your keeper. He's the one that keeps you connected. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The sun shall not strike you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve you from all evil if you're what? Connected. He shall preserve your soul. The Lord shall preserve your going out and coming in from this time forth and even forevermore. The Lord is my help. My help comes from the Lord, true hope, holding on to the promises of eternity, eternal promises of God, not what man says, not what the world says. That's all false hope, trying to bring discouragement to mankind. 1 John chapter 2. First John chapter 2, verse 24. Everybody okay? And let's speak this together, please. Verse 24, 1 John chapter 2. Therefore, let that abide in you which you heard from the beginning. If what you heard from the beginning abides in you, you also will abide in the Son and in the Father. And this is the promise that he has promised us. Eternal life. These things I have written to you concerning those who try to what? Deceive you, manipulate you. But the anointing which you have received from him abides in you, and you don't need anyone to teach you. Why? Because you know the truth. But as the same anointing teaches you concerning all things, and is true and is not a lie, and just as it has taught you, you will abide in him. And now, little children, abide in him. And when he does appear, we may have the confidence and not be ashamed before him at his coming. If you know that he is righteous, you know that everyone who practices righteousness is born of him. Born of him. Born of him. That's a state of being born again. It's a position, spiritual position of being born again. What the enemy wants to do is disconnect you from that place so you move out of that chamber. If he can disconnect you, you lose hope, or you're misled, or you're discouraged. Amen? And then you're looking for everything else to fulfill or bring encouragement, but what is true? Does everybody get this? This is important. This is the enemy's one of the great deceptions that he uses. False hope. People do things for the wrong reason. Well, I'm doing this in hope of this. I'm doing this in hope of that. I'm doing this. Does everybody understand that? Our hope is in Christ. I do things to want to please him. My hope is that what I'm doing is pleases him. That's what my hope is. Everybody has hopes in the world. Amen? Of course, hope is associated with future, faith in the future. That's where people use the word, I wish, but it's actually I hope. You know, you're wishing don't do stinking nothing. But your hope in Christ will do something. But if it's false hope, it ain't going to do nothing. Does everybody get it? But our hope is in what he says. That's it. Anything else will bring discouragement and false hope. You'll lose your identity and lose connect. You'll be disconnected. Hallelujah. Where I say go? 1 John chapter 1. Oh, we did that. Colossians 2. Go put your Colossians on. Praise God. Gosh, is it warm in here or what? Whew. Slam. Well, move your pages real quick if you're hot. That way you can cool your neighbor. Whew. Colossians 2, verse 1. For I want you to know what a great conflict I have for you and those in Laodicea, for as many as have not seen my face in the flesh. Thank you. Man of wisdom. For as many as have not seen my face in the flesh, that their hearts may be encouraged. That their hearts may be what?
Encouraged.
Come on, read it with me. That their hearts may be encouraged, being knitted together in love and attaining to all riches of the full assurance of understanding, to the knowledge of the mystery of God, both of the Father and of Christ, in whom are hidden all the treasures of wisdom and knowledge. Now this I say, lest anyone should deceive you with persuasive words or false hope. For though I am absent in the flesh, yet I am with you in spirit, rejoicing to see your good order and steadfastness of your faith in Christ. As you therefore have received Christ Jesus the Lord, so what? Walk in him. Rooted and built up in him, established in the faith as you have been taught, abounding in it with thanksgiving. Beware, though. Beware. Beware lest anyone cheat you through philosophy and empty deceit, according to the traditions and common sense of men, according to the basic principles of the world, and not according to Christ's promises. For in him dwells all the fullness of the Godhead bodily, and you are complete in him who is the head of all principality and power. Everyone say, I am complete,
in him.
Not in anyone else. Nothing else. You're only complete in him. Again, the Holy Spirit causes us to fight for what is truth. Passing through the lies, passing through the lust, passing through the false hopes, passing through the encouragements, passing through sinful desires and all deception of evil influence until the comfort of peace is brought by the true presence and power of God Almighty. You fight through till you get there. Why? Because that's how you stay connected. See, people don't fight. They fight for all false hope. People are actually fighting for discouragement and don't even realize it. 2 Timothy 3. In verse 1. Is everybody there? But know this, that in the last days, what?
Perilous.
Perilous times means difficult times. Difficult times will come. We are in those times right now. There's difficult times. There's more influence than people can imagine. Children are being born into this influence, and they have no idea. For men will be lovers of what? Themselves. That's a demonic influence. Lovers of money, another demonic influence. Boasters, proud, blasphemers, disobedient to parents, unthankful, unholy, unloving, unforgiving, slanderers without self-control or control over self. Brutal, despisers of good, traitors, headstrong, haughty, lovers of pleasure rather than lovers of God. They have a form of godliness, but denying its power. False hope. And from such people, what? Turn away. For this sort are those who creep into households and ministries and make gullible men and women, load them down with sins and led away with various lusts. They're always learning and never able to come to the knowledge of the truth to be free. He uses an example now. Jannes and Jambres resisted Moses who do these. So do these also resist the truth. Men of corrupt minds disapproved concerning the faith. Why? Are they connected or disconnected? Disconnected. But they will progress no further. For their folly will be manifested to all as theirs was. But you have carefully followed my doctrine. Manner of life, purpose, faith, long-suffering, love, perseverance, persecutions, afflictions which happened to me at Antioch. In other words, burned through them. Why? Because I fought through them. At Iconium and Lystra, what persecutions I endured, and out of them all, the Lord did what? All of those trials, all of those tribulations, all of those discouragements, he brings you through. Why? Because you stay connected. Yes, and all those who desire to live godly in Christ Jesus will suffer persecution. But evil men and imposters will grow worse and worse, deceiving and being deceived. In other words, they are constantly have false hopes and they will pass it on. But you must continue in the things which you have learned and been assured of, knowing from whom you have learned them. What's your source? And that from childhood you have known the Holy Scriptures, which are able to make you wise, because that wisdom is from above, for salvation through faith, which is in Jesus Christ. Because you're staying connected. All Scripture is given by inspiration of God and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness, that the man or woman of God may be what? Complete, immovable, thoroughly equipped by the power of God for every good work. Perilous times, difficult times with many false hopes of man, influenced by evil forces of lies, lust, control, deception, leading many away from God into oppression, discouragement, and no hope. That's why people commit suicide. Psalm 107. You know, you hear about all, you know, I don't know if you know, there's many testimonies and stuff, especially about history, where when the stock markets fell, people were jumping out of windows, committing suicide and all kinds. Why? Their hope was in their money. People killing themselves because their boyfriend or girlfriend broke up with them. What an idiot. It's terrible. Why? Because their hope is in the wrong thing. It's the wrong source. Kill my, or they go do something stupid to harm themselves, self-infliction. That's what the enemy wants to do. Psalm 107, verse 10. Is everybody there? Psalm 107 in verse 10, and we will speak it. Praise God. Those who sat in darkness and in the shadow of death, bound in affliction and irons, because they rebelled against the words of God, or the hope, true hope, amen? and despised the counsel of the Most High. They rejected his counsel, correction, and direction. Where did they end up in? Darkness. Therefore, he brought down their hearts with labor. They fell down and there was no help. Then they cried. They turned. They repented. Out of the Lord. Out to the Lord. In their what?
Trouble.
You know, the word says we go into afflictions when we fall away from following God's word. And he saved them out of their distresses. God is so faithful, even when we're boneheads, idiots, and morons. He brought them out of the darkness and the shadow of death and brought and broke their chains in pieces. He freed them. Oh, that man would give thanks to the Lord for his goodness, for his wonderful works, the children of men. For he has broken the gates of bronze and cuts the bars of iron in two. Fools, because of their transgression and because of their iniquities, were afflicted. But you know what? They go back. Why? Because they're not holding on to true hope or the promises of God. You know, God says, grab hold of me and I'll grab hold of you. He said, fools, because of their transgressions and because of their iniquities were inflicted. Their souls abhorred all manner of food. They drew near to the gates of death. They cried out to the Lord in their trouble, and he saved them again. He saved them out of their distress. He sent his word and what? Healed them and delivered them from their destructions. All that men would give thanks to the Lord for his goodness and for his wonderful works to the children of men. Many call God rescues, but many refuse to abide in his word, and they go astray again because of false hope. Why? This false hope is demonic, and it continues to pull people away from his true word of promises where there is true hope. In John 16. Verse 25. John 16, verse 25, let's speak it. These things I have spoken to you in figurative language, but the time is coming when I'll no longer speak to you in figurative language, but I'll tell you plainly about the Father. And that day you will ask in my name, and I will do as you say, that I shall pray the Father for you. For the Father himself loves you because you have loved me and have believed that I came forth from the Father. I have come forth from the Father and have come into the world. And again, I leave the world and go to the Father. His disciples said to him, see, now you are speaking plainly and using no figurative of speech. Now we are sure that you know all things and have no need that anyone should question you. By this we believe that you come from God. Jesus answered, do you now believe? Indeed, the hour is coming. Yes, has now come that you will be scattered, each to his own, and will leave me alone. And yet I am not alone, because the Father is with me. These things I have spoken to you, that in me you have peace. In the world you will have tribulation, but be of good cheer. I have overcome the world. So if you're connected to the source of his promises, his presence, then you overcome. Amen? You're an overcomer. We need the Holy Spirit for interpretation. He's essential. He's the one that interprets everything. Amen? And 1 John chapter 5. Our hope, again, is in his promises, always. And it's not what he can do for you. He's already done it. Our hope is staying connected in him. That's our hope. Does everybody get this? staying connected. This is true hope. That's future hope. That's living from the future. That's faith in the future. Anything else is false hope. Amen? That's why when things aren't going whatever, there's that area where we just cast it out to the Lord. And there's a saying we use, in that God's got a plan. Why? Because our hope is in Him, not in us. So when things are not going the way you think it should, it's God's got a plan. Does everybody get this? God's got a plan. Why? Because I'm going to stay connected to His plan and not mine. Then I'm walking in true hope. God's got a plan. Well, business is bad. God's got a plan. Well, such and such is sick. God's got a plan. What does it say? My trust is and hope is in the Lord, and I'm going to pray according to His will. That's His plan, right? In verse 1, 1 John chapter 5 and verse 1. Whoever believes that Jesus is the Christ is born of God, and everyone who loves Him, who begot, also loves Him, who is begotten of Him. And by this we know that we love the children of God when we love God and what? Keep His commandments. For this is the love of God, that we keep His commandments, and His commandments are not burdensome. His request is not burdensome. For whatever is born of God overcomes the world. And this is the victory that has overcome the world, our faith or our connection. Amen. Who is he who overcomes the world but he who believes that Jesus is the Son of God? This is who came by water and blood, Jesus Christ, not only by water, but by water and blood. And it is the what? Spirit who bears witness, because the Spirit of truth. And there are three that bear witness in heaven, the Father, the Word, and the Holy Spirit. And these are one. And there are three that bear witness on the earth, the Spirit, the water, and the blood. And these three agree as one. If we receive the witness of men, the witness of God is what? Greater. For this is the witness of God, which He has testified of His Son. He who believes in the Son of God has a witness in himself. He who does not believe God has made him a liar, because he has not believed the testimony that God has given of His Son. And this is the testimony that God has given us eternal life, and this life is in His Son. He who has the Son has life. He who does not have the Son of God does not have life. These things I have written to you who believe in the name of the Son of God, that you may know that you have eternal life, and that you may what? Continue to believe in the name of the Son of God. In other words, maintain your connection. Psalm 103. Your faith is the connection to the truth of the eternal realm, and power to overcome influences of this world. Psalm 103. Is everybody there? Psalm 103 and verse 1. Let's speak it. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me, bless His holy name. Bless the Lord, all my soul, and forget not His benefits, His promises. Why? Because that's true hope. Other than that, anything else is false hope. But it first says, bless the Lord, all my soul. Why? Because if you're blessing Him, you're connected. If you give Him all the glory and everything you do, you're connected. And then there's benefits. These are the promises of true hope, not false hope. He says, don't forget these now. Verse 3, who what? Forgives all of your iniquities, mistakes, stupidities, sins, transgressions, and who heals all of your diseases. Of course, when you repent, hello? Who redeems your life from destruction, who crowns you with loving kindness and tender mercies. What a dad. Who satisfies your what? Your mouth with what? Good things. He's going to put good things in them. So that your youth is renewed like the what? Eagles. Praise God. You can stay 33 the whole time while you're on the side. These are promises. He says, don't forget them. Stay connected with them. Amen. I'm going to close at John chapter 10. Hallelujah. John 10, verse 7. Then Jesus said to them again, most assuredly I say to you. You know what it says? Then Jesus said to them again. Again. And again. Most assuredly I say to you, I am the door of the sheep. All who ever came before me are thieves and robbers, but the sheep do not hear them. I am the door. If anyone enters by me, he will be saved and will go in and out and find pasture. Not pastor. The thief does not come except to what? Steal, to kill, and to destroy. I have come that they may have life and that they may have it more abundantly. That's a promise. But he first must be your shepherd. That means you're connected. Has everybody got it? You're connected, what, through faith. You're connected because you have true hope, not false hope. And you have a desire to please him. Because if that desire ain't there, then you're not connected. Then you're of the world. Amen? Remember, the enemy wants to bring disconnect. Jesus said in verse 11, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd gives his life for the sheep. But the hireling, he who is not the shepherd, one who does not own the sheep, sees the wolf coming and leaves the sheep and flees. And the wolf catches the sheep and scatters. In other words, he does not warn. The hireling flees because he is a hireling and does not care about the sheep. I am the good shepherd, and I know my sheep, and am known by my own. As the Father knows me, even so I know the Father, and I lay down my life for the sheep. All other sheep I have which are not of this fold, them I will also bring. And they will hear my voice, and there will be one flock and one shepherd. Therefore my Father loves me, because I lay down my life that I may take it again. No one takes it from me. But I lay it down for of myself. I have power to lay it down, and I have power to take it again. This command I've received from my Father. Praise God. False hope must be exposed. Amen? It must be exposed and removed. Your hope is in nothing else but him. His promises and who he is. Stop hoping for everything else. God's will be done. Don't do something to hope for something. Does everybody get it? You know, people do stuff for God and hope that God will bless them in another way. Let God be God. You do it because you love him, amen. Not because you're trying to get anything from him. Amen. Amen? Oh, hallelujah. I could go on all day on that one. Thank you, Lord. We are honored and blessed, Master. Thank you for exposing false hope, false promises, and discouragement. May we constantly be encouraged by your presence, by your word of truth, by your power, and by your sons and daughters that encourage one another with your truth. In Jesus' name. And everybody said amen.